first.
Tonight on CN8 News with Arthur Fennell, America at War, Day 18, taking down Saddam. As the next level of fighting begins on the streets of Baghdad, stay with CN8 News for complete coverage of America at War.
Then on Money Matters Today with Mary Fay, you can qualify for a mortgage, but can you afford a house?
What a stiff. Back then, my achy joints made it hard for me to get around. So I tried OsteoBiflex. OsteoBiflex has helped so many renew their joints and their lives. It's different from pain relievers. It safely lubricates joints and rebuilds cartilage. So over time, you're more flexible and comfortable. OsteoBiflex from Rexall. Put some life back in your joints.
100 mile per hour winds. Roofs blown off houses. 20-foot storm surge. And that's just the beginning. Get ready for 5 amazing nights of the most incredible storms you'll ever see. Storm Week begins tonight on the Weather Channel with Raging Hurricane. Watch nature wreak havoc on people, property, and paradise. Raging Hurricane, it's intense. Are you ready? Storm Week starts tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific. Only on the Weather Channel.
Storm Week, tonight at 8 on the Weather Channel. And now, here's your local on the 8s. Currently in your area, 30 degrees with light snow. Forecast for your area. Your extended forecast.
You're watching the Weather Channel. Live by it.
Coming up next on Weather Center, the chance of severe thunderstorms looms over the South tonight. Several Gulf Coast states are under severe weather watches.
In the other half of the country, winter just does not want to give up. A number of major metros in the Northeast got snow today, and we'll have the very latest coming up.
Chicago, you're one of the places that saw snow from the same system that's moving through the Northeast. We've got more details straight ahead. Hi, and welcome to Weather Center. I'm Christina Abernathy.
And I'm Carl Parker. Thanks for joining us. About 5 inches of snow in New York City today, and it's the 7th of April. You'd think you'd be going absolutely crazy.
Oh, I know.
To live in New York City or Hartford or Providence, anywhere up there.
Poor people in the Northeast. I know they've got to be just sick of the snow.
Yeah.
And it's going to be kind of cool. I know. It's just going to be cool and kind of yucky for the next few days.
Not going to change much at all in the next couple of days. Snow started falling in New York City at around 10 a.m. Some schools were closed. In anticipation of the 3 to 5 inches that has fallen across the city, LaGuardia, JFK, and Newark all reporting 5 inches of snow, and the Yankees game was also canceled today. The spring storm will also stretch the city's winter weather budget. Sand and salt trucks are once again out trying to clear the roads of snow and ice. Well, a big part of what happened today was that high pressure in eastern Canada very strong and very cold high pressure has been building down, so there's plenty of cold air in place to support snow. Temperatures now in the 20s in interior parts of the Northeast. Freezing mark now in New York City and also in Albany, 28 in Burlington, and it's now 35 in Philadelphia. That's the first part. The second part is that we've had a series of impulses making their way off towards the north and east here, grabbing Atlantic moisture and throwing it back into that colder air. And so we have light snow now falling across much of the state of New York, northeastern Pennsylvania, on into Connecticut and Rhode Island, and we think the snow will eventually start falling here in Boston. Here's a closer look at New York City, and things finally beginning to taper off here. There could be some freezing rain or drizzle tonight, so be aware of the possibility of slick roads in New York and farther westward into eastern Pennsylvania. We've had heavier snow in eastern Long Island the last couple of hours, light snow across most of Connecticut and also into Providence, where you could see, say, 6 inches by the time it's all said and done. And then farther northward, we've actually had snow, or actually sun, I should say, in the last couple of hours here in Boston, but the snow will be moving in short order, and we think about 2 to 4 is a possibility by the time it's all said and done. There's a precip forecast through midnight tonight, and 3 to 6, as indicated by the white here, southeastern New York, much of Connecticut, much of Rhode Island, and southeastern Massachusetts. Now tomorrow there could be more wintry weather in interior parts of the Northeast and New England, maybe some snow and a bit of a mix. Watch out for light snow in the morning hours in Boston, about 34. Pretty quiet in New York City. Morning showers, we think, in Philly and also in D.C., and about 50 for your high tomorrow in Washington, D.C. In the Midwest, got a great big upper low here, and light snow has been falling with that in many areas, and it's been very persistent. So we've actually had as much as a foot of snow right around the state line between Iowa and Minnesota, still snowing in those areas. More snow here across Wisconsin and northern parts of lower Michigan. And it's very chilly. 32 now in Chicago, 28 in Green Bay, 27 in Marquette, where it was 9 below this morning, 31 in Des Moines, and 32 in Lincoln. We could find more wintry weather tomorrow in some spots, maybe some light snow in Chicago, about 36 for your high, late day rain showers in St. Louis, warming up here in the High Plains, 62 tomorrow in Rapid City, and 47 tomorrow in Minneapolis-St. Paul. Christina?
Well, let's head to the southeast, where unfortunately we have the threat of severe weather. Severe thunderstorm watches are in effect in parts of Texas, including San Antonio, as well as the Houston area, then across Louisiana, including New Orleans, and all the way over into the panhandle of Florida. And we've already seen some rough weather earlier around Houston, around New Orleans, and let's just take a closer look at the Houston area. One storm that moved through earlier dropped some hail in the Houston area, and we're continuing to watch Houston for the chance for stormy weather, but we're certainly seeing plenty of stormy weather now in Louisiana. In Iberia Parish earlier, we had half-dollar size hail. So some of these storms definitely mean business, and look out around Lake Pontchartrain because we have special marine warnings in effect for the thunderstorms there. And you can see just how widespread the stormy weather is. Where you see the reds and the yellows, that's where some of the worst of it is. New Orleans, you'll want to keep an eye on things too. We see much more stormy weather off to your west heading in your general direction, so it's not over yet. And we had farther eastward, and we're seeing a lot of wet weather that extends over into Georgia, into the Carolinas. This rain has been persistent and heavy in some areas, and there's even more rain in the forecast. And because of that, we're concerned about flooding. Flood watches have been issued from southern Virginia back through the Carolinas all the way into southeastern Texas. So do watch out. Remember that most fatalities and flash flooding situations occur in automobiles. So we always urge you, do not drive through water-covered roads. It is very difficult to determine the depth and the strength of the water. It can be very deceptive. So again, even a little bit of water can cause a lot of problems. It's stronger than you think, so don't take any chances. Tomorrow, more rain, more thunderstorms. Charlotte and Atlanta, New Orleans and Houston, especially during the morning hours in Houston. Now back to the west, a lot of the southwest is quiet, but we do have some snow here in Colorado, some wet weather in the northwest, and there's more in your forecast. We see the clouds around, and underneath those clouds, you're seeing the soggy weather. And for the Cascades of Washington, we could even see some snow. And of course, some snow here in Colorado, where we could pick up 1 to 3 inches of snow through midnight. But more wet weather for Seattle and Portland tonight and on into the day tomorrow. The rain is in the forecast. 82 in Los Angeles, 87 in Phoenix, and we should see plenty of sunshine. So some pleasant weather for you across the southwest if you like sunny skies and dry dry conditions. Quick check of the forecast tomorrow. More wet weather across the southeast, and it's going to linger on through the day. Stay with us.
Works like magic.
Bleaching action whitens teeth like no toothpaste. Plus White's whitener gel bleaches away stains to whiten teeth. Plus White 5-Minute Whitener Gel.
Watch my dark circles, puffiness, and wrinkles disappear instantly. Sudden Change Under Eye does it. It's guaranteed to give you these results instantly. Sudden Change Under Eye Lift.
Every day, the South wakes up to billions of allergens, from cats and dogs to ragweed and dust. That's why there's Clarinex. Clarinex provides receptor protection to help block histamine. Get 24-hour non-drowsy allergy relief anywhere, anytime. Side effects are similar to sugar pill, including sore throat, dry mouth, and fatigue. Indoor allergies, outdoor allergies, wherever. Talk to your doctor about Clarinex.
Brittle nails that break and won't grow? Get Nutri-Nail. Short brittle nails grow in just 5 to 7 days. Nutri-Nail. Short brittle nails grow. Guaranteed.
Suffer with scars from surgery and other causes? Then you need ScarZone, the scar diminishing cream to help fade away scars. Your scars need ScarZone.
This is a Honda certified used car. Even if you take away its 150-point inspection, its comprehensive 12-month, 12,000-mile warranty, and its concurrent 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, you're left with one undeniable, completely comforting fact.